Okay, that is a nice view. Not quite a full-on O'Neill cylinder. Maybe once it's finished being constructed, it'll be resemble that. Okay. And Kesh, Andros, and Anderson. Now I can save my game! I talk to my computers when I fix them, but that's still a bit much. Dude, armored hamsters, that would be a Krogan. I never really thought of them as giant space hamsters before, but that now makes so much sense, considering this is a BioWare game.
This is Nexus Control to Hyperion.
It isn't
good to
what
have
we want,
you here.
But what choice do we have? How
Excellent.
The hell should I? All right, what happened?
To who?
To whom? And your goddamn father. Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with everything. And
your
right
face
now,
and apparently
I
the
just
rest of
want
you.
To know what happened with Alec. Not how he died. I pulled those logs. What happened with Pathfinder?
In the moment, it saved my life. But it seems my father meant for me to get the role, eventually.
It isn't hereditary. If we wanted an inbred monarchy, we could have left half our gene stock back home. Not home. The Milky Way. This is home. This
trying to wrap
mess.
Your brain around the situation.
We don't have a lot of options, Ryder. Maybe you'll prove your father right. After 14 months of failed colonization, forgive me if I don't
Okay,
hold my breath.
Lots of dialogue options here.
There's also this strange technology. Has anyone studied that?
We've tried. Not me. The brains in research. They're supposed to know their business. The current excuse? The tech we dug up on Mars was more advanced, but it was plug and go. The tech here thinks different?
Designed by
I
Apple?
Don't know. We've mostly avoided it. And from what the Hyperion logs say about Alec, maybe that's good.
Alright, so, that kind of makes sense considering the tech in the Prothean tech in the old galaxy, and to a certain degree also the tech behind the mass relays, which is in turn designed by the Reapers, was designed to facilitate technological direction development in a particular direction, in a way that galactic civilization builds out in the fashion that the Reapers can collect it efficiently, and also the technology is something that can't fight back against the Reapers as effectively. Whereas here, God knows.
How do you fit into the Nexus leadership?
I oversee the actual settlement effort. As the number of outposts is currently less than ideal, my influence is limited. As Tan is quick to remind me, left a perfectly adequate career as a chief officer. Provincial capital, too. Only a new
well, congratulations, you're now in charge of a galaxy.
And here we are.
Once Island. We get this all fixed.
You called my father Alec. No one does that.
A lot of us joined the initiative because of his vision. What he shared of it, anyway.
Were you friends, or...
I'm not your new mother, if that's what you're asking. Or his friend. He hated that I didn't use his title. But no one's a pathfinder until they've pathfound.
That's
something.
Fair.
Much like a colonial director without colonies.
You've had no colony successes in over a year? How many tries is that?
Less than you'd think. The Scourge, spoiled worlds, exiles, hostiles. We can't just plop down an outpost and expect picket fences. We need the Pathfinder and Sam to scout, evaluate, and inspire. The initiative promised a goal.
Oh yes, the world is definitely not stable.
And if it had?
Beautiful utopian horseshit. Colonies that produce and support each other. The Nexus as citadel, not headed by Tan, or even me.
Yeah, so the shooty guys, how about them?
Hostile aliens. We can't have been that naive.
We expected life. Not an enemy that refuses to talk. They don't attack. They disinfect. We're nothing until we're bacteria. Sorry, 14 months and you stoop to poetry. That's how bad it is. Not sure who started it, but we're calling them Ket. Kandros will know more. Maybe too much.
You don't trust him?
I trust him to defend us. I do not trust a rising military influence in a supposedly civilian initiative. We came here to make history, Ryder, not repeat it. Ugh, goddamn poetry.
All right.
Excuse me, Director Addison.
Ryder?
It's Pathfinder.
Ryder, we're starving here. If we don't get a foundation of outposts to feed the initiative, we might as well be 600 years dead.
She's got a thousand.
What you're up against.
I don't know if this is a falling into the uncanny valley, or if this is a case of thousand-yard stare after years of stare brought on by over a year of raw, unchecked despair. All right. So, Nation Wall. Map, what we got? Andros. Hand that moves the story forward. Yeah. So, let's go the other way. Let's talk to everyone else before continuing with the story.
Yes, I know the Hyperion docking unannounced caused some switches to blow. That's fine. I don't care. We know the problem is more widespread than we thought. We're working to fix it. That's all.
Alright, how you doing?
There you are. Hope the others haven't been giving you a hard time. There's a lot that needs doing. At least with the Hyperion hooked up and feeding us power, my team and I can get more work done.
Well, what do you do?
What kind of work do you do as superintendent?
I was part of the team that originally designed and built this place. I keep the station functional, or as functional as possible, considering.
Well, impressive for a Krogan, considering that what you're known for in the other galaxy is beating the crap out of stuff.
I noticed there aren't a lot of Krogan around.
You haven't spoken to Number 8 yet, have you?
Number 8?
Tan. Ask him why most of my people left. He'll have opinions. I can tell you this much. When the mutiny happened, a deal was made. My clan were supposed to settle matters and, in return, get more say in the
initiative. I take it that isn't how it turned out.
Did the deal go through?
The clan held up their part, but Tan had a meltdown when he found out we wanted more say around here. Then Addison's assistant, Spender, pretended he never made the deal in the first place. It was a mess, but I don't blame my people for walking out. We're done.
Yeah.
With your clan gone, why did you stay?
It's complicated. The station and my clan both need me here.
Why do you call Tan 8?
Because he was 8th in line to take over the Andromeda Initiative. I like to remind him of that now and then. Keep him humble.
That's like on par with the nickname for 97 or whatever it was from Alien 3.
When we left the Milky Way, the Krogan were still dealing with a genophage.
Right. The genophage. A little gift to our people from the Solarians.
The Solarians who are running this project.
That sterility virus they infected us with left most of our children stillborn. Only 1 in 1,000 survive.
No wonder your people have such a problem with Solarians.
Some wounds never heal. Not that my ancestors didn't provoke it. They did try to conquer the galaxy. The Solarians were forced to respond. And it's not fair to blame it all on them, either. The Solarians developed the virus, but it was the Turians who deployed it. I'm hoping that's all in the past. Plenty of blame to go around, but Andromeda is about new beginnings. My people need that more than most.
What about the Krogan here in Andromeda?
There's no cure for it. But my clan was starting to show a mutation against the virus. A natural defense. During the trip to get here, Krogan underwent gene therapies to enhance the mutation.
That's one way to deal with genophage.
So you used those 600 years to your advantage. Give the adaptation more time to develop.
Yeah, well...
Yeah.
so far the humans all over.
But I think we made a dent.
I'm kind of interested to see what the makeup is of the station itself.
Almost 4%, which is a lot better than what we had. Beyond all the statistics, it means more Krogan children will live.
Our ship was primarily a human-populated ship, with a few Asari on board. We'll have a more balanced alien population on board the Nexus once we start thawing people out.
What sort of problems have you seen on the Nexus?
Situation's gone to shit pretty much sums it up. There's arcs missing. Some idiots tried to mutiny and take over, then more idiots offended my clan, so they left. And to top it all off, the founder of the initiative, Gian Garson, was killed.
What happened to Gian Garson?
Killed in the Scourge disaster. Her and a bunch of the other leaders.
That's probably something we're going to end up investigating over the course of the game.
And I thought the Hyperion had it bad when we arrived.
Yeah, the Genophage is a big thing with Krogan society in the first three games. It's
more uptight than ever.
Something when your society, when people try to cause your society to go extinct by making them almost all sterile.
My team and I are repairing what we can. If we don't get materials soon, things will go downhill. Fast.
All right, and that covers pretty much everything on the questions here.
Nothing more for now.
Try not to die out there.
I will do that. Then talk to Kandros.
Tempest crew should report to the docking area at once.
This is a nightmare.
I know that look. The others bent your ear, did they?
Something like that?
You get used to it. Just focus on being a Pathfinder. Can't argue with results, though they'll try. Anyway, welcome to Militia HQ. Excuse the mess. This office fields militia work, Nexus security, and looking for the Turian Arc.
What's the word on the Turian Arc?
Scattered readings. Some indicate the Natanis was destroyed, others that people are alive. Who knows? If you need anything, come see me, even if it's
You're
just a vent.
You're taking this rather well, it sounds like.
What do you know about the enemies we've encountered? The Ket.
Yep, jogging is there.
We usually see them on worlds with those alien structures. The Ket don't take kindly to anyone studying them.
Maybe
some
religious?
Why. They don't talk to us. Every time we cross paths, there's a fight or they take prisoners.
Why? What do they want?
No one knows. But I've seen their weaponry and what they do to those prisoners. I want them a long, long way from the Nexus.
Hmm.
Are the other Turians managing okay?
So-so. We're not good at sitting around in a crisis. Service before self gets drummed into us at boot camp. That's probably why so many of us are in the militia. We like to earn our citizenship, whatever galaxy we're in. But it's hard to focus with our arc missing.
Yeah. The eye animations are a bit much.
I was tired of being the good one.
The good one?
The Kandros family is old military. There were expectations.
I think,
you know,
then my Turians are supposed to be kind of bird-ish or bird-inspired, and so the eyes might be meant on that, because bird eyes tend to move around a lot. But the way Kandros' face is modeled feels less like feathers and more like bone. Don't know if that's deliberate.
You talk like you weren't part of the leadership. How did you end up commanding the militia?
I was escorting a prospecting team on some moon when those Ket found us. They
beat
us like cattle for experiments. I managed to get loose, snatched a gun, and freed the others. By the time
I do appreciate the actual blinking.
Back to warn the Nexus, everyone looked at me like I was in charge.
That sounds familiar.
The militia grew from there. Funny, once the heat is on, all kinds of people rise to the top.
It's rough out there. I might need backup if you can spare the people.
Yeah.
I have strike teams specializing in assault and extraction. If you need serious firepower, my Apex teams have you covered. In fact, I could give you authority to dispatch them. It'll cut down their response time.
Thank you.
Our current ops are on the terminal. See if there's anything that could use a shot where it counts.
All right.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Let's look at the strike team missions real quick.
This is This console reports on the militia's current strike team missions, Pathfinder. Please speak with Tyrann Kandros for authorization to participate.
What am I going to do? It's not right.
The Turian.
It's not fair.
What's wrong?
Side quest.
Oh my, you're... So it's true. A Pathfinder has found us. There's hope at last. Maybe you could help. You're impartial. This whole thing has gotten so political. My husband, he's locked up and slated for exile for a crime he didn't commit.
What? Yeah.
What exactly was he convicted of?
They don't exile you for petty theft. Well, maybe this bunch would. They say it's murder. They're calling him the first murderer in Andromeda, but the dead man was his friend. He wouldn't have... There are witnesses and evidence, but it's all circumstantial. At worst, it was an accident. His name is Nilkin Rensis. He could give you the details if you were willing to speak with him. Please.
Sure.
I'd be happy to.
Oh, thank you. I'm sure the jailer will allow you a visit. Please, tell Nilkin I love him.
Okay. Alright. Not a long jog.
Tempest crew should report to the docking area at once.
Another Turian. A lot more Turians around here.
Help you?
Pathfinder Ryder. Here to see Nilkin Rensis.
Ah, our murderer. Wife's here all the time. Guess she told you her sob story. Nilkin, you're moving up in the world. There's a Pathfinder wanting to chat with you.
The Pathfinder, huh? They called in the big guns to exile Andromeda's first murderer.
Your wife's all broken up over this. She says you didn't do it, and that she loves you.
She's a wonderful person. At this point, it's too late.
Kinda.
They found me guilty.
Yeah, sorry, you're actually closer to space elves.
I was part of the futile effort to set up a colony on Eos. We were on our last legs, overrun by hostiles, our leader dead. The security chief, Reynolds, my friend, he refused to call for evacuation. I argued with him. Everyone saw.
Last I checked, getting into a spat wasn't against the law.
There's more. He ordered us to regroup and counterattack. We were moving through a sandstorm. I saw movement, thought it was the Ket, and... I guess I panicked.
Friendly fire incident.
Witness saw the chief's chest.
Yeah, that sounds like a friendly fire incident. And first rule of combat, friendly fire isn't.
Sounds like an accident.
That's what I told them. But I was enraged when we argued. There's a recording. It's ugly. Everyone's certain I did it on purpose so we could evacuate. Only my word otherwise.
Don't throw in the towel yet. I'll review the evidence. Maybe I can find something that'll help.
That would be great. You're a Pathfinder. I'm sure Kandros would give you access. Maybe there's still hope.
Alright, so go back, chat the Paths. Kandros? Oh, hey! What can I sell for cash? There we go, much cash. Oh, color-coded weapons. All right, how do they compare to... Avenger, slightly better damage than the I don't have to buy that yet. I don't have a shotgun yet. Inventory. Can I upgrade? Oh, can I upgrade my guns now? Helmet, arms, armor. They're blueprints that I found. Okay. A lot of these are guns I picked up from Mass Effect 2 and 3. I wonder if any of this is stuff that unlocked if you beat Mass Effect 3. Only blade one. Type rifle yet. Alright. Is it possible for me to... Alright.
That's the console for our strike teams.
What are they?
Assault and extraction squads. When we need the best, I have Apex. Combat experts who yep. signed up to defend us. Since you have a front row view of the cluster, I can give you authority to dispatch them.
Pardon me. To cough.
I'll deploy your people carefully, Kandros.
Appreciate that, Ryder.
Kandros or Kandros?
Apex can handle themselves.
Andros like Davros, or Andros like Gross. Also need to talk to you about Axis the Prisoner.
No news on the Turian Ark yet. Or is this militia okay. business?
I spoke with Nilkin Rensis, the man found guilty of the murder on Eos.
Yes, our first murder here in Andromeda. I wish it had been our last. When the colony attempts failed, it didn't help spirits that a high-ranking officer was killed by one of our own. The mutiny here on Nexus was probably inevitable, but this acted as a spark.
That's a bit stretch.
Doesn't seem right to put all that on him.
Of course it isn't, but that's the perception. Despite the lack of physical evidence, everything added up. His only defense was, trust me, I didn't mean to do it.
Yeah.
That is the difference between murder and accidental death.
In this case, motive plus opportunity plus eyewitness account equals murder. Look, knock yourself out. A key witness, Cassidy Shaw, works in operations. Go ahead and talk to her. And there's a recording of the perpetrator threatening the victim. I'll let you cue it up on the console there. As far as I'm concerned, this case is closed.
Bye, Kandros. Duty calls.
You and me both, Pathfinder.
Console! Let's watch the... murder record the recording of the alleged threat.
The Nexus versus colonist Nilkin, evidence 7A.
Hiram! They've seized the compound! Call for evacuation!
We're not giving up, Nilkin. We're taking it back!
No! I'm not letting your ego get us killed! Even if I have to... No! Get him off me! Get him off me!
Yeah, that's not the best phrasing.
Engineering update. We are working on accessing more power from the Hyperion. All non-relevant repair requests.
And let's talk to Shaw.
All right, moving on. Docking clamps? Fully active and engaged.
Docking hatch integrity. Cassidy Shaw? I'm Sarah Ryder. I'm looking into the...
That hair!
Oh man, I thought that was over with. Have you heard the audio recording?
Yep.
Yes.
I helped pull him off Chief Reynolds. You could see it in his eyes. He was gonna kill him. Then in the sandstorm, I had a pretty clear view of the chief. He looked right at Nilkin and shouted, no. Then his chest burst open. I'll never forget it. The look on his face was pure shock.
Yeah.
Did you see any Ket in the vicinity?
Nilkin said so, but not that I could see. Still, the sandstorm was severe. Visibility wasn't great.
If they'd fought and Nilkin threatened to kill him, why was Reynolds surprised?
Fronts fight, say things they don't mean, maybe even hurt each other. But you don't expect your best friend to shoot you. To me, that's the saddest part. The chief's heart was broken right before it exploded.
Get back to poetry again.
Did Nilkin seem remorseful?
I lost sight of Nilkin in the turmoil. When we found him, he seemed in shock. He couldn't speak. He looked nauseated. Could have been guilt. The reality of the act sinking in.
Reynolds was leading you back to retake the compound. Did you agree with that?
It wasn't my place to agree or disagree. He was ranking officer. In retrospect, it is ironic. If he hadn't been killed, we all probably would have died.
All right, that is...
I appreciate the information.
Of course. It kills me we had to leave him behind. He deserved a proper funeral.
So the body was never examined? Important piece of a murder investigation.
Tan wouldn't allow a mission to go back for him. Said it was too dangerous.
So presumably... So this all goes back to talking to Tan. Presumably once I get the scout ship, I can head back there and find the body and investigate and determine one way or another if this was actually a murder or not. Or manslaughter. Or your bog standard friendly fire incident. Yeah, that is definitely hairstyle by liquid paper.
Engineering update. We are working on accessing more power.
This is the planet where we landed. Habitat 7. It wasn't even close to livable.
That's been true of every world we found. Ryder, we were discussing your next expedition.
Ah, good.
Good. I was starting to wonder who was
number 8.
Director Addison is entitled to her opinion, and mine overrules hers.
Does she know that?
I oversee the entire initiative, and I have decided to give you a chance to prove yourself. To that end, the Scourge dealt us a serious blow. Whatever it is, our scientists theorize it's not natural.
An artificial energy cloud?
It wasn't here when we left the Milky Way, yet it rendered all the golden worlds unlivable. Then there's the aliens you ran into.
The cadence of your voice is weird.
We found scattered around the cluster. They'll do anything to prevent others from accessing them. It seems murder isn't exclusive to the Milky Way. And now the challenge is to settle a world in spite of all that. This one here. Eos.
How?
You need to increase the viability of the planet so we can establish an outpost. Then we can bring more colonists out of stasis. The more colonists we have, the more resources we can gather to support the Nexus. Everything depends on it. There are 6 worlds we hope to settle.
Okay, but you said every planet you found is unlivable, so how do I...
A good Pathfinder would relish the
challenge. You basically have to figure out how to terraform a world.
Right. I think I should go check...
Oh, by the way, on Beam Stream, Naked Pete is now following.
For another Pathfinder?
Placing bets on people is part of my job. Some of them pay off. Others...
Well, I appreciate that you consider me, that the bookmakers have made good odds on me. Laid good odds on me.
Just point me to my ship and I'll be out of here.
They're prepping it now in the docking bay. The coordinates for Eos will be in the computer. And when you have a moment, we should discuss the missing arcs.
I was wondering about the...
Something wrong.
Light headache.
Ryder, please see me and Sam Nude on the Hyperion. Your implant needs attention, and we need to discuss a confidential matter.
No. I'm fine.
And before we go, I also need to talk to you.
Ryder, you have my condolences.
Wait, two other quests.
I appreciate it.
I didn't know him very well, although I understand he played a key role in planning the initiative. I'm sure he'd be concerned that we still have several arcs missing.
Any idea where they went?
Nothing certain, but tens of thousands of colonists
yeah.
are unaccounted for. It paints the initiative.
Either that or ice cream headache.
Unflattering light. Did you have some other business?
Yeah, murder charge.
I'm looking into the Nilkin Rensis murder charge.
And?
I want to go to Eos and retrieve Chief Reynolds' body.
That isn't usually Pathfinder business.
First murder in Andromeda, and I'm impartial. Figured you'd want to get it right.
Settling an outpost comes first. But I suppose I have no objections. Physical evidence will only bolster the case.
The more certain we can be, the better.
All right, but let's keep it quiet. I don't want people thinking we're reopening the case. I hope anything you find reaffirms what's been done, but if it sheds a different light, we'll deal with it. We'll send the coordinates of the murder scene.
Thank you. Good luck. And let's ask the rest of the useful questions here. So, missing arcs.
Any more information you can give me on the missing arcs?
No, and that is the distressing part. The Asari, Turian, and Salarian arcs are completely unaccounted.
The Turian arc surprisingly appears to be doing okay despite being set the wrong place on purpose.
I fear the worst. Should you find any clues, please investigate. Without the other arcs, the promise of the initiative can never be fulfilled.
Are there any other arcs we should expect?
We had hoped Quarians would be part of the first wave. But before departure in 2185, we got word they had technical problems with their ship. It seems they're also bringing along Drell, Hanar, and other species as well. Managing all of their biological needs caused complications. We won't see them for some time.
I'm looking forward to potentially having a Drell party member in the next game. Or even better, a Hanar.
As director of the initiative, are you in charge around here, or what?
If the others would allow me...
Million people crying on one and held around. What that actually was the Batarian arc crashing into a... crashing into something.
So how does anything get done?
In theory, Kesh handles the Nexus's physical operations, Kandros runs the militia, and Addison manages colonial affairs. I oversee all of it. In practice, we argue, debate, and yell at each other until a decision is made.
Ah, it's like Citadel Council.
It is maddening.
What's their problem with you?
I am not Gian Garson. Our founder was charismatic, eccentric, larger than life. Traits.
Well, you've got the eccentric part, right?
She and her inner circle perished in the Scourge, some at the hands of the Exiles. Some never made it out of stasis. I was deputy assistant for revenue management. Then all seven leaders above me died. I was next in line for the role.
Revenue management and seven leaders above you died, huh?
So, you're an accountant?
Don't let that fool you. We are all capable of more than we know.
Of course, I've read Neptune's Brood. I know you don't mess with space accountants.
Life had its detours, and I went a different direction.
By the way, watch my review of Neptune's Brood on the YouTube channel.
I saw a chance to try the path not taken. While I may not be setting foot on New Worlds, my authority can ensure that you do.
Right. Sorry.
Oh, it's fun to charter on accountant, sailing on the wide accountancy.
What do I need to consider in making a planet viable?
Assuming the planet supports life, an outpost is critical. People like a roof over their heads, and you'll want to eliminate any
through diplomacy or bullets.
Whether that's the cat or other terrors lurking in Helios, colonists being murdered on sight can be discouraging.
That's an understatement.
Also, scouting and mapping terrain is a priority for any Pathfinder. And don't forget forward stations. You'll want those.
What can you tell me about forward stations?
I was afraid you'd ask. It's mostly what the engineers tell me. A forward station allows mining, equipment repairs, and resupply for field teams. I mean, who wouldn't want that? But seeing as how every colonization effort has failed, it's just theory at the moment. you get to test it out, Ryder.
Basically, it sounds like as a system, it's going to work like uncovering campgrounds in Dragon Age Inquisition.
Sounds like the Nexus has had a rough time of it.
Publicly, I would say
by Neptune's Brood, I'm referring
challenge.
To the book by Charles Strauss. Again, I have a review of that on my YouTube channel.
It's been a disaster.
Link is over... URL's over there somewhere.
Senior leadership. Even the founder of the initiative, Jean Garson, is dead.
How did Jean Garson die?
With the rest of the leadership. When the Nexus hit the Scourge, a large wing of stasis pods was destroyed. They were killed instantly. These people traveled 600 years and died before they even woke up. Jean Garson never glimpsed Helios. She never saw her vision realized.
Sucks.
Kandros mentioned something about hitting the Scourge. How did it play out?
Criminal elements took advantage of the emergency and preyed on people's fears. An uprising followed. We had no choice but to turn to the Krogan to deal with them. They crushed the mutiny, and the criminals were banished. Exiles, we call them. I doubt we've heard the last of them. They're led by an outlaw, Sloane
As opposed
Kelly.
To Ned Kelly?
She used to be one of ours.
Who is this Sloane Kelly?
She was head of security on the Nexus. She opposed the uprising at first, but eventually turned traitor and joined them. Misguided sympathy for the plight of the common citizen.
Oh.
Nonsense.
Catch you later, Aaron.
A direct threat to our existence.
There don't seem to be many Krogan around.
The archive will be up on the stream, and I've got this chopped up into bits for
last place you want
to go up on the YouTube channel every Tuesday and Thursday.
Nothing more. Good for fighting and lifting heavy
objects. Catch you later.
When they didn't get what they wanted, they left.
Boy, it's straight up, it's almost like the genophage free version of what happened back in the Milky Way.
Why don't you like the Krogan?
It's common knowledge that they are a violent, ignorant species. Long ago, they waged nuclear war on one another. Their planet was decimated. My people tried to uplift them, but the Krogan could never tame their worst instincts. What if they bring their tempers to Andromeda?
Basically you're racist against the Krogan.
What more can you tell me about the initiative?
It represents the greatest migration ever attempted. No one had ventured beyond the Milky Way before. We've all left home in search of freedom, fortune, perhaps a new beginning. We are the bravest souls each species has to offer. I hope the Nexus will serve as the seat of government for us all.
Why do you think most people came?
There are thousands of reasons. One for every colonist.
This is a speech I have very carefully rehearsed during my copious spare time while I've contemplated the void.
To fulfill them, while we cannot promise they will find it, we can't facilitate the search.
Dream, the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe.
The Nexus is home to
melting pot, but not a mosaic, so it's clear that we're not actually Canadian.
The hope is that this station will one day serve as the governing body in Andromeda. Though I'm not sure what they were thinking, lumping Krogan into the mix. As a Solarian, my kind tend to have a low opinion of them. Nothing I've seen here has changed.
Why couldn't we have sent Doc Morden Solis? I've already talked to you about your dislike of the Krogan.
What do you know about the early days of the Initiative?
As most everyone knows, Jean Garson's vision made it happen. She was an entrepreneur on Earth. Wealthy. Young for a human. Garson had the idea for the initiative in the early 2170s, I believe. Many thought leaving the Milky Way was impossible. But she persevered. And as with most great ideas, the doubters were wrong.
Well, that covers all the bases.
That's all. Thanks for your time.
I'm happy to help. You will find our futures depend on each other's success. Good luck.
Talk to the scientists. And talk to the talk to the scientists.
Looks fine so far.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine. My arms got the brunt of it.
Stuff exploding like this happen often?
Back right after the mutiny, we had a lot of this happening. But not lately.
I wasn't there during the mutiny.
Lucky. I thought we were done with this, honestly. That maybe I was just being paranoid.
You know what they say. It's not paranoia.
If someone is out to get you, yeah. Third time this week. It's getting worse. First one was small stuff. This one could have hurt bad if I'd been closer.
That's not good. Sorry. Understatement.
Yeah. And now I have more repairs.
Whoever's doing this has to be stopped before someone gets seriously hurt.
That's what I'm trying to do. But I'm an engineer, not a PI. I've scanned all the potential sabotage areas I can think of.
A PI, Pathfinder, Investigator, until he works for me.
Sounds like a lot went down before the Hyperion docked.
Yeah, I guess. Wait, that's it. You can't possibly be involved in this. You weren't even here during the mutiny. Would you, if you have time? Maybe you could help me. If they start hitting
critical systems. I'm taking on a side quest.
Sure thing. What can I do?
If you could scan these other panels while I fix this one, that'd really help. I've sent the locations to your Omni tool. Just send me the data when you're done.
No, I'm fine. And I don't know. It just blew up.
Find out why. Be careful.
Colonel.
Pathfinder, to cover their tracks, the saboteur is overloading power to this panel from another junction relay. You can scan and trace the connective wiring to locate the surrogate panel. Scanning power junction relays. This panel is malfunctioning. Without more data, I cannot determine if this is a normal malfunction or sabotage.
I'll just disable power to the panel until Raj can check it out.
All personnel, be aware of any suspicious activity. Security is on heightened alert.
Scan and trace the wiring to locate the panel that the saboteur used.
Disembarkation procedures for Hyperion are on hold. Please await further instructions.
All right, up here.
This panel has been tampered with.
Send the data to Raj.
Yes, Pathfinder.
All right. And then one more.
As to who it might be?
Yeah. All these panels were worked on by Zara. I just can't believe it.
Security video logs confirm that Zara Kellis worked on these panels, as well as the one Raj Patil encountered.
Well, shit. Any idea where she is now?
Kellis is currently working on a panel on the Hyperion.
Oh, that's not good. That's, you know, where everybody works and is the nerve center for operations on the station. Okay, actually down there. Wait, Hyperion main deck. Oh, I actually have to go back to this. Ah, this is how this works for loading areas. This is our new elevator, apparently. So, you're doing sabotage. Are you Cerberus?
Zara Kellis?
Yes?
I have evidence you've been sabotaging the Nexus.
What? No, I'd never... I've been looking into this myself. I have the
scans. You've got a British accent like Cerberus.
Here. I'll transfer the scans I took to your Omnitool.
Funny. Raj was investigating the same thing. And it led us to you.
My scans point at Raj as the one. So unless someone was setting us both up, I just don't understand.
The data Miss Kellis has accumulated is strangely similar to Mr. Patel's. A third party seems likely.
Looks like someone is using both you and Raj to cover their tracks.
They need pretty high-level access for that. Still, it's better than thinking Raj could have done this. But it means all the data I have is useless. Wish I had access to the security cams. I bet we could find something there.
You stay put, so whoever did this doesn't realize we're onto them. I'll check out the security cams. Raj, you there?
Yes. How did it go? Is it... Is it really her?
Wasn't her.
Alright. Yeah, back this way.
She had proof pointing at you. I figure someone's been messing with you both. Just keep a low profile and don't talk to anyone. I'm on it.
Am I going back to the station? Yes, yes I am. Do 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 do. Like Clue all over, it's like, yeah, it's like Mass Effect 1 all over again. Except we're not spending as much time in the world's slowest elevators.
This file is useless. Let's check another. And another scrambled file.
Coincidence seems unlikely.
Let's check another. This file is also corrupted. Definitely.
But less corrupted.
You need pretty high clearance to mess with the security camera files. Somebody working for Kandros, maybe.
That is the most probable scenario.
Think you can get enough out of the files to find a match using biometric scans, Sam?
The files were badly scrambled. But if I combine all the available identifiers, it might work. Based on the limited information available, we are looking for a human male, assigned either to the Nexus or Hyperion. You will need to conduct scans from close proximity.
Got it.
Well, the good news is, whoever this human male is, it is probably someone on Nexus.
Please be advised that Hyperion docking procedures are now complete.
Biometrics do not match.
Please be advised.
Oh, Nexus security transferred to the Hyperion. Okay.
This person is not a match.
Do I have to head back to the Hyperion? Don't. Yeah, I must have to head back to the Hyperion again. Alright, let's. Once I finish this quest, I'll take one more record break. Have I leveled up anything up? I have 2 points. Let's put one into Nova. That and I'll read those later. Here we go again. All right.
Accurate match.
Oh boy, that's not suspicious at all.
Scan results show a partial positive. Target is most likely suspect.
Who is he?
Dale Atkins. Reports to Kandros' department. Assigned to station security.
Hi, Dale.
Dale Atkins, right? We need to talk.
Look, not to be rude, but I have work to do.
Is that what sabotage is called these days? Mm. Work?
You're pretty arrogant for the new kid. You don't even know what's been going on.
Proof says you've been up to no good.
Figures. Screw this. Screw all you hypocrites on this station. You weren't here when they kicked out our loved ones. Mutiny? We just wanted answers. My sister is out there. I don't even know if she's alive or...
I'm sorry for what happened, but setting explosives isn't the answer.
Neither was sending people into exile because they didn't agree with policy. I don't care what you think. The mutiny leaders were right to demand to know what was going on.
You could have hurt people. Killed them.
Like those who got killed when the leadership had the Krogan stomp on my friends? I'm done talking. I confess, it was me. Do whatever you want.
We can't let you stay on board.
That wasn't what I wanted to pick.
Wait, you...
But it'll work.
You'd let me go?
If you call exile letting you go, sure. You leave and you don't come back.
I'll leave.
I leveled that up. Okay. Take one more quick record break.